Welcome to another episode of Women in Sports Unplugged. Our guests today are two young badminton players, Tarini Suri and Saili Rane. Saili Rane is an international badminton player and currently plays singles for India. She was ranked third in the senior nationals last year, winner of the gold medal at the Iceland International in 2018 and Norwegian International in 2017. Saili has participated in numerous international and national competitions. 13-year-old Tarini Suri is a budding badminton player. In the 5 years that she has been playing competitive, she has won a lot of tournaments and has shown great potential and promise. She is the current Maharashtra state champion in doubles and is also ranked number 3 in the national doubles ranking. Thank you so much, girls, for agreeing to come on this show. I am so, so excited to talk to you on the show today. Thank you so much. Saili, I want to begin by asking you, what does sports mean to you?
I think to me, it's more like, I guess, freedom and like being myself, I guess. Like, I can really express myself on court. I think that I can be myself. Yeah, I think for me, it's more like that, you know. I feel very alive when I'm, you know, doing anything related to sport. Yeah. Otherwise, I don't feel.
Yes. No, I like that. Freedom and, you know, you feel alive.
Yeah.
It's obviously something that you're so passionate about.
Yeah, definitely.
And it is your profession, which is wonderful. So freedom and being alive. I love that.
Yeah.
Tarini, so you tell me, what does sports mean to you?
So for me also, like, it's a great way that I can express myself. And it's like a way of life. Like, I love playing. I love being on court. And it's taught me a lot of stuff, like determination, because you have to, like, think about the game and sacrifice, because you have to give up a lot of stuff if you want something. So, yeah, and sportsmanship is very important. So, yeah. That's what it means to me.
Yeah. No, a lot of things you said, which we will come back to, especially about the sacrifice and a lot of hard work that you do. But sportsmanship, I think I come from the corporate world, and we always say that when you want to see how a person's character is, see how that person is on a sports field or while they're playing sports. And sports, I think, helps you later on in life as well, in terms of when you move on from sports to doing some other professions. So I envy the two of you. Playing sports is just so wonderful. Saili, but tell me, you know, you've been playing the game for a while. What was the role that your parents played in encouraging you to take up this game?
I think, like, my father, I think because of him, whatever I am today is just because of him. I mean, because I come from a very middle-class family, you know. It's very, when you want your child to be a doctor or an engineer, you know, when you come from that background. And then, yeah, I think, yeah, it's all because of him. I mean, I think otherwise it was impossible. Like, he used to travel with me. He was working, you know, with SBI. But still, you know, he used to manage his leaves and, you know, travel with me. And I think whatever he has done is, like, I don't think anybody can do it.
No, you know, a lot of sports persons I've interviewed, there's one thing in common. The role of the parents has been just so important in their lives. And you mentioned about the sacrifice, and even, you know, Tarini talked about the sacrifice. I think there's a lot of sacrifice that the parents make, you know, when they are helping their young superstars, you know, follow their dreams. I think it's wonderful because, like you mentioned, you know, everyone wants their children to become either doctors or engineers. But, you know, your father encouraged this. So I think it's so wonderful. And now we have a sports amongst us. Tarini, what about you? How important has the role of parents been in your life?
So for me, my parents have actually played a very important role. My mom's actually actually a driving force. She like helps me. She's never missed any of my matches, and she's one of the most animated parents I've seen. Like she's jumping up and down on her chair, and like on the other hand, Miss Ufrish is the most calm, poker face. Like she won't give even a little bit away, even if I'm losing or winning. She's not gonna. And Mom on the other hand, jumping up and down is like. So yeah, it's really fun. Like I feed off her energy. So.
Good, and she's always there for all your matches as
well.
Yeah,
she's never missed even one. Yeah.
Yes. But you know, you mentioned coach, so I want to actually ask both of you, and maybe Tarini, since you were speaking, you can tell me, what do you think is the role of a coach? How has it changed your approach to the game?
So for me, Miss Ufrish is like a second mother. She's really helped me. She will help you improve not only as a player, but also like as a human being. She instills one of the most important qualities, like most of the important qualities in you. And so, yeah, she's a blessing to have.
Oh, nice. To say a coach is a blessing. But Sally, tell me, how important do you think is the role of a coach? Did it change the way you approach the game? Did it help you reach the level that you have today?
I think with me, because I've played at the national centers and I've also played in many other academies.
Yes.
Now I'm very independent and, you know, I'm doing my stuff on my own. Of course, like with Ufrish ma'am, I take advice from her. But I think, it's very important in the beginning. I mean, you know, because I think that trust and the mutual respect and, you know, everything should be there, and it's very important, I guess. Yeah.
Okay. So, you know, we talked about parents, we talked about a coach. I'm very keen to understand, you know, what's the role a school plays. Tarini, you're still in school. How do you balance between school and studies? When I was growing up, the school only focused on studies. And if I wanted to play sports, it was on your own time, or they would not give any special, they would not provide any flexibility. So how do you manage school and your education? And Sally, I will come back to asking you about it.
So for me, like, school is really supportive. Like, I'm in JB Pettit, and they're like, you have like the best connection with your teachers. They are like really supportive. They take a lot of pride in my wins, and they like really encourage me even if I've lost. And they've never hesitated to give me like leave during exams. And yeah, they're the best. And like, we're a girls' school, and they encourage like girls, all our girls, at least one sport we have played, all of us, like they encourage. And it's not only academics, like we do all extracurriculars. Like we have sailing, throwball, basketball, football, every sport that you can think of. And they just back everyone up to do whatever they want. Yeah.
Well, that's great. I wish I was going to school right now. I grew up at the wrong time. Sally, what about you? How accommodative was your school when you were growing up?
I think they were very supportive. Like, I remember I should just go for exams sometimes, you know, like, yeah. Also school, my college, I think everything, they were like, yeah, very supportive to me, yeah.
No, I think it's very important the role of school plays. So I'm co-creating this show with Sports Village, and they work with a lot of schools in India, across India, and they're also helping set up some, you know, facilities, etc., where the schools didn't have. Their aim is to have 100 million girls actually playing sports in the country. So when I was speaking with them, they said it's so important, the foundation that the school provides, or the flexibility. Like if you're going for training, etc. And both of you have also reaffirmed that fact, that how important a school is. So Sally, tell us about your routine. I've always wanted to ask professional sports people how their daily routine is like. You know, what time they get up, their food, their exercise, it must be quite rigorous.
But I think right now it's like, normally like I have like 3 sessions in a day. But yeah, right now it's just 2 sessions, and we don't have morning session, like early morning session right now. So I think that's the good thing. Otherwise, like I have to get up at like 5:30 in the morning, which I don't really like, but yeah.
And do you follow a controlled diet?
Yeah, I do.
Okay.
Because like when I was young, I mean, that time it was all right to eat anything, and like it's not show on my body. But now It does. So, I mean, yeah.
Sally, come on, you're still young. So don't say that. Tarini, tell me, pre-lockdown, what was your routine like? I know during the lockdown, your routine must have all changed. But
yeah,
tell us a little bit about your routine.
So morning training, 4 o'clock, get up, 6 o'clock CCI, train till around 7:30, get ready for school, reach school 8 o'clock, 8 to 2:15 school. I get like 15-minute nap in CCI and then 3 o'clock court till 6 o'clock, reach home 7:30, eat food, do homework and sleep.
Oh gosh, I'm exhausted just listening to that routine. And then get up again at 4 a.m. Yeah. And I'm sure your mother is also doing the same thing. And that's what I was talking about, the sacrifice that the parent has to make. Okay, Sally, tell me, what is your favorite badminton memory? It could be something in your childhood or a favorite match you have.
I think, my favorite badminton memory would be like when I won my sub-junior nationals. So I won double crown, basically. I won the women like in singles as well as doubles. I think I won against Sindhu.
Oh.
That nationals. My dad was there and he was like crying and all that stuff.
I'm just getting goosebumps listening about it. How wonderful. Tarini, what is your favorite memory of badminton? I'm sure you're going to build lots of memories, but so far, what is your favorite badminton memory?
So whenever someone asks me this question, there's only one match that comes to my head. So it was, we were playing national selections in Tirupur, quarterfinals doubles, me and my partner. It was like 24-23 in the third set. We were on deuce and we were down 23-24. And suddenly out of nowhere, there was this huge rally of like 50 strokes. And in the rally, I slipped on my own sweat while defending a smash. And then my opponent tapped it again on me. And then I dived from a kneeling position onto my stomach and somehow the stroke went over the net. And then she didn't see that I was still on the floor. So she played to my partner and we won the point. And then after that, we won the match because they're like, if they can take this, then I don't know what they can do. So they actually just gave up after that. So we needed just 2 points to win and we won that match. And in that tournament, we from the first round had all matches of 3 games. It was really fun, yeah.
Oh, wow. The way you've described it, it's literally, I can visualize that scene, you know, and 50 strokes. My God. Yeah. Oh, wow.
And mom was still jumping up and down on this seat. And then I looked at her and she was like, did you actually just take that?
Wow. Okay, Sally, tell me, when did you first know that, or when did you first feel that you want to play, you know, for India, you want to play this game professionally?
So actually, that's a funny story, actually. So I used to play in the building with my other friends. So my neighbor, he saw me playing and he used to play badminton at this club, you know, Khajim Khana. So he asked my dad, you know, like she plays really well, you should, you know, give her some professional coaching or something like that. But my dad was like, no, because nobody in the family has played any sport or, you know, anything. So my mother was like, no, it's better she, you know, only studies and, you know, like that. So then, like, 3 months, they just passed. And then, again, like, he saw me playing in the building. And then he was just like, okay, come with me. I'll sign you in, like, you know, So he took me to this, there's this small club near my house. So he took me there and then called Balkanji Bari, and then that's where I started playing, actually. So he's the one, you know, who paid my first fee for badminton as well. So it was not my parents.
And how does it feel to play for India and win medals? The thrill, the excitement, the pride?
Yeah, I mean, I cannot even express myself, you know. I still feel that, you know, I'm in a dream. Yeah. Yeah, something like that. Yeah.
No, I mean, I've always watched people on the television or when I've seen live sports. Holding the Indian flag, I just feel the whole the pride and the thrill must be just something different.
Yeah.
So Tarini, tell me, do you ever feel that you would want to play for India and represent the country or play this game professionally?
Of course. Like, I've been training for just that, so... Yeah, every time, like we, like suppose in Olympics when we saw Sindhu with the flag, me and mom both started like tearing up because like it's so, like I don't even know how to like put it, but it's really like, it's like a dream. So yeah.
Yes, and you're working towards it. You're making all the sacrifices, Tarini, and you know you have a lot of role models and including Sally. So you know you have a lot of encouragement and then. You know, your parents are supporting this right through. So I'm sure we are going to see you represent India and win medals. Sally, tell me, if I ask you, which are the two, and I'm going to ask Tarini the same question, which are the two sportswomen you really admire? They don't have to be in the field of badminton. They can be in the field of badminton, but if I had to ask you that, who would they be?
I think first one would be Saina Nehwal, definitely, because like I grew up watching her, and you know, and when I was playing, like she was senior to me, like she's my senior, so I've seen her like grow as well. And I think Saina would be the one, and the second one would be Mary Kom. I think definitely, I think she's a legend. Nobody can be her. I mean, she's just great. Yeah.
Yeah, no, Mary Kom is a huge inspiration, and she's a mother as well. And
exactly.
I mean, I think just the fact that she came back, into the sport after that needs a lot of grit, a lot of determination.
Yes.
Go ahead.
Yeah, and I think from the background she came from, and it's very difficult. I mean, that's the reason I really admire. I mean.
Yes.
Yes,
absolutely.
Yeah.
Tarini, which are the two sportswomen you admire?
So yeah, like Sally said, Mary Kom was one of my answers because like after, like she was like so determined to come back after she had children, and like it's just really, I don't know how she did it, but like she came back stronger than what she was before. And yeah, so even Serena Williams is the second one, because the same thing, coming back even stronger after having children, and the way they like, I don't know, they just, I really don't know, but those two are my favorite. So.
Yes, and you know, not because this program is Women in Sports Unplugged, I think, men will never understand what it takes to coming back to play professionally, actually even coming back to work in any career. You know, balancing your, but in sports, it's even more because it's a physical thing. Yeah. So it's just so commendable for women who come back to their careers. It's more mental and how they manage their work life. But for sports women, you know, to come back and to play at that international level, commendable. Absolutely. I completely agree with you. Before we move to the fun section of the talk, which is a rapid fire round, which I'll tell you about in a bit, I want to ask this question to both of you. Sally, let's start with you. What is the message that you would like to give to other girls out there to actually look at sports and look at sports as a career? What is the message that you would give to other girls out there?
I would just say that work hard in any, whatever you do, just give you 100%. Otherwise, don't do it. And if you really like have the passion and determination, then you should just go for it. I mean, because like I have done it, and I think, it's not impossible. I mean, just go for it. Yeah.
Yes. Passion, determination, go for it, and nothing is impossible.
All
wonderful messages. Tarani, what would you tell other young girls? I'm sure, you know, in your school, there won't, I don't know how many girls are playing sports, but what would you tell other young girls and how would you encourage them that, yes, one should play these sports, the sacrifice is worth it?
So I would say that they should pick up a sport, like, especially in our country, because the girls are not, like, thought to be, like, timid and docile. I think they should pick up a sport, and, like, because it gives you, like, mental and physical strength, and it also, like, helps you deal with situations when you're under pressure. So it also helps in life, and, like, sports has no side effects, so it'll help you in whatever you do. And it gives you opportunity to compete with boys, which is a great high. Like, when I'm compared to the boys, I feel really good. Because, like, physical strength for me is, like, one of my main, like, my strengths. And when I'm compared to boys, it's, like, really a good feeling. So,
I love that. Go girl, when you're compared to boys, it's a great feeling. You know, it's in all careers, let me tell you that. But a lot of good points you brought out, you know, how it helps you play under pressure, which takes back to the point I mentioned earlier. And that, you know, you can see a person's true character actually when they're playing sports. You know, how they react to stress. How are they in, you know, fair play and good sportsmanship. It actually translates into their personal lives and their professional lives. So, yes, I completely agree with all the points you said. So, girls, are we ready for the fun part of the talk? So, I'm going to say 5 words. And I'll say the word. And then both of you have to tell me the word that comes into your mind. Okay? So, we can do Sally first and then Tarani.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Are we ready?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. So, the first word is... food. Telly.
Pasta. Pasta.
Pasta. Yes, nothing tastes like carbohydrates. Tarani, food.
Sushi.
Sushi. Oh, it's my daughter's favorite as well. Sushi. Okay. The second word is hobby.
Swimming.
Swimming. Tarani?
I don't know. I love music. I just love listening to music. I play piano and guitars.
Oh, I didn't know that. Wow. Hidden talents. And music, I call music my best friend. I learned how to sing. I learned Indian classical music. So I would also say music is my hobby. Unfortunately, I couldn't make it my profession. You know, that's one of my regrets if I say that. Okay. Third word. Worst exercise.
Burpees.
Oh God! Burpees. I hate burpees.
Well, it's the same for all 3 of us. I can also tell you, I hate burpees. Yeah. And you girls must be doing I don't know how many when you're doing your exercise.
Circuit training burpees, kangaroo yes. jumps.
Okay, I can completely relate to that. Okay, the next word, holiday, Sally.
Croatia.
Wow. Game of Thrones was also shot there. Croatia, famous, more famous. I know, I've heard it's a beautiful country. I haven't had the opportunity to travel there yet.
Yeah.
Harini?
Hawaii.
Ooh. Another place I haven't visited. So both of you have now, you know, both the cities are, both the places are added to my must visit list. Okay, the last word, movies.
I don't really watch, but...
if you had to pick one movie...
One movie, I think. I don't know.
Okay. It doesn't matter.
Zindagi Na Milegi Dobara.
Gosh, oh, nice. Won't believe it. I was thinking of exactly that movie. after listening to the two
of you, can't get bored to it. You just can't get bored of it. It's like the best.
No, I know. I think it's a cult film, you know. It's just such an amazing film. Yeah. So many messages, so many takeaways. Follow your passion. Yes, I would have picked that movie as well.
But do you know, I have watched one movie like 3 times in the theater. Is that that's 3 Idiots? Yeah.
Yes, 3 Idiots.
Yes.
Yeah, 3 Idiots. Yeah.
My top 3 Bollywood are 3 Idiots. Yeah. Jawani Hai Deewani and Zindagi Hai.
Yeah.
Okay, Tarani, we know which generation you belong to. That's why they're your top 3 Bollywood films. But 3 Idiots was shot on the campus that I went to study, which is IIM Bangalore. And so I could really relate to it because so many of the scenes, especially the water tank, I used to go to that water tank many times and have similar conversations with my friends. But good movies. Good movies. But thank you so much. I really enjoyed speaking with the two of you, and so many amazing messages the two of you have given, and I'm sure the viewers also found this as interesting and enjoyable as I did. You can find this talk on a podcast on Spotify and Apple iTunes, Zip Talks, on YouTube channel #ZipToFitness, and on Instagram, ZipToFitness. Thank you so much.